43, I had a question coming out of chapter 6, number 74. And here we were told that IQ was normally distributed. So that's a buzzword, okay? IQ is normally distributed with a mean of 100 and a standard deviation of 15. So my variable in this problem is IQ. All right, and we measure IQ. So I've got a continuous numerical variable. I mean, the units on it are just the score that you get when you're talking about your IQ. So maybe points, if I had to really specify a unit here. It doesn't give me any unit specifically, but I could say points. So there is the answer to part A. There is my squiggles. All right, so I know that I will be making the bell curve, and I will put 100 under the peak, and I can scale it by 15s. All right, and so with that, that's the answer to A. Part B says find a probability, right? So I've got my capital P, and it says that a person has an IQ greater than 120. So I need my variable to be greater than 120. And as I take a look at that, let me go ahead and show you what's happening on the x-axis here. So you can see I've got my variable labeled on the x-axis. I also labeled my x-axis with the letter X. All right, and then I've got probability along the y. And you can see that I've got 100 under the peak. All right, now, if I'm thinking about z-scores, right, this is a z-score of 0. So one standard deviation above the mean, that would be a score of 115. Two standard deviations above the mean would be 130. So if I'm talking about 120, that's going to be in between one and two deviations above the mean. Now, I don't need those numbers written there. I just want to give it to you for scale reasons. So whenever you have a probability statement, start inside the parentheses, right? We need x greater than 120. So I need to identify 120 on my x-axis. And because I have a greater than symbol here, I'm going to go to the right. So if I'm heading to the right, that means I want to go from 120 over to positive infinity. So there are my low and my high, and then my mean and my standard deviation. And when I pump that back into my calculator, I get about 9%. And that 9% matches my graph. That's a relatively small area that I shaded, right? If this entire area has to be 100%, it makes sense to me that this blue part is about 9%. All right, so there's part B. All right, so part C is saying, hey, what's the IQ to qualify for Mensa? And Mensa is in the top 2%. So you can imagine I want to find now the top 2%. And the top 2%, that's great. We want that area under a curve, but your calculator is not built in tops. It's built in percentiles. So, if you want the top 2%, that's the same cutoff as the bottom 98%, right? Because we're, again, using the complement rule. So if I want to find this top 2%, I can't plug in 0.02 to my calculator using inverse norm, because that would actually give me the second percentile, and I want the 98th percentile. So when I plug in 0.98, the mean and standard deviation, I find out that, hey, if you score about 130.8, then you're going to qualify for Mensa. So that's where I'm getting that number there. Okay, and then last but not least, it asks us, hey, what are the cutoffs for the middle 50%, right? Basically, what's the IQR? So if we're talking about middle 50%, right? So if there's 50% of the area under my curve in the middle, then there's 25% on a side. And we have to convert middles to percentiles because, again, your calculator, right? Our calculator is built in on down mode. It's not built in middles. It's not built in tops. Another way of saying that is it's built for percentiles, or what we called in chapter one, cumulative relative frequencies. All right, so we have to look at a certain area on down. That's what percentiles are. So we're not cutting it off from left to right. So let's start to piece this together. All right, if I want this number, whatever this cutoff is, right, because I want the middle 50%, but I need to figure out what percentile is happening here. So I need to calculate the area from here on down. So if we look at the area under the curve from there on down, if I just want to shade right there, you can see that it's 25%. So the cutoff for the middle 50%, right, we would call it the 25th percentile, at least the lower bound, 25th. Oops, I forgot the percent symbol. All right, percentile, right, which we knew that anyways. We talked about Q1. Q1 is the lower quartile. And then in the same vein, if I want to head here, if I want to find this percentile, let me go ahead and pick a different color to shade with. I'll pick pink. So if I wanted to shade all of the area from that cutoff on down, you can see that I would shade all of this area, right? And basically, ooh, I picked up my pen, but that would be 50 plus 25, and that would be 75%. All right, so we've talked about that as well. We've talked about the 75th percentile is Q3, but now you're seeing it play out again. So if I want the cutoff, again, for the middle 50%, so the middle 50% is cut off by the 25th percentile and the 75th percentile, all right? And so when I plug those into my calculator, I'm going to see those respective IQ scores, all right? Thanks so much, everyone. Bye.